Hey y'all, how's it? Oh no. Oh no, that's the first time I've spoken today. Hey y'all, it's Annelies, and I went to Dapper Day. And if you don't know what Dapper Day is, how do I even explain it? I feel like it's not that hard. Let me look on the website and see if they have a better explanation for it than I can formulate in my head right now. So from Dapper Day's website, it says, definition, dapper, neat in trim and appearance, very spruce and stylish. Dapper Day celebrates refined style from yesterday and today. Join our elegant outings to museums, Disney parks, and more. Dress up a little or a lot. We welcome all refined fashions from vintage classics to chic contemporary looks. Need an outfit? Shop our Dapper Day Expo each spring and fall at the Disneyland Hotel with bands, dancing, and nearly 30,000 square feet of vendors. I mean, that explained it actually pretty well. Dapper Day is a day that people who love Disney and looking nice, I guess, celebrate by going to parks, and according to this, it says they go to museums and more, but I've only heard about it at Disney parks. It happens twice a year, one in the spring, one in the fall, and Dapper Day is it's technically, they say it's one day, but there's 2 days of the expo, and then people will dress up on the first day as well. I went to both days, but I went to the Dapper Day, like the big day, all day, and the first day just for like an hour. Up until recently, I have not lived in Southern California. I'm about 25 minutes away from Disneyland Resort right now, which is the coolest. And my voice sounds so bad. And what's really great about being near Disneyland Resort is that I can participate on things like this kind of on a whim. I used to be about like 7 to 8 hours away, and so I had never been to a Dapper Day, but I'd always seen the people that I like follow on Instagram or follow on YouTube post about it, and I thought it was so cool. So the day this year for fall 2018 came around, and I kind of went, why the heck not? And so you know what I did? I did the damn thing, and I went to Dapper Day. So I wanted to talk about, one, my outfit, because I was pretty proud of how quick I threw it together, and I really liked how I looked, and two, Dapper Day itself. So like I said, there's like day one, and then like Dapper Day, because the expo is for 2 days, and I'll get to the expo in a minute, because it's a lot different than you might think it is. And according to that website, it actually kind of explained it really well. Anywho, for the expo, you get this little wristband. This little wristband for this year gets you into the expo, which was $10 this year. I don't know why I thought it was gonna be more. So it cost you $10 for both days. So I said, you know, why the heck not? Let's go. And I decided I wanted to go to Dapper Day on the first day. Now, what I also learned is that people go to the Dapper Day Expo without looking dapper. I mean, that's my interpretation of their outfits. I personally wouldn't call like cargo shorts, old flip-flops, and a t-shirt dapper, but like maybe you do. I'm not here to judge. I was like, okay, I really want to have like the Dapper Day outfit nailed down, but let me see what's in my closet that I can make dapper. And I think the thing is Dapper Day, what I've learned at least, and especially from that little explanation, which why didn't I read any of this before going to this thing? Who knows? But it's more about your interpretation of it. It's kind of styled around the idea of opening day of Disneyland. I should have said that way earlier. Disneyland opened on July 17th, right? When did Disneyland Resort open? I was right. So July 17th, 1955, Disneyland opened for the first day. And the idea of Dapper Day is the closest idea, and what most people go off of, is dressing as if you were there on opening day. But then people do like Disney bounds, and just people look nice, or people do like kooky outfits that are based off of Disney, or like inspired by things, or whatever. I didn't do any of that this year, but I would like to 1 year. Anyway, I found this dress in my closet, and this dress I wore to my graduation the first time I graduated. I got this dress from Target, and it's kind of hard to see, but it's kind of this, it looks red on camera right now, but it's orange, I promise you. It's got like this little V-neck here, and then this skirt kind of fluffs out a little bit, and then it has this, it has this little detailing on the bottom. It's a cute time. As you may know, if you follow me on any social media or you've watched my videos before today, I'm a theater person, so I have character shoes, and that's what they look like. So they've got this little T-strap on there. They're cute, pretty comfortable, except I did the dumb thing, and I wore them without any socks or leggings or tights or anything like that, so I got pretty bad blisters on my feet, just from walking around the parks for like an hour. Also, I can do a musical in these, but yet I cannot walk around Disneyland in them. I don't know why. Would not recommend doing that. And then at the expo, one, I've been looking for a pair of new sunglasses, but two, I saw these, and they were pretty cute and dapper, and it's these cute little like wingtip sunglasses. Aren't they not the cutest? I love them. Like, look, wow, like, like 50s or 60s or 40s or 20s, who knows? Who knows what era these are? But I think they're cute. And they're actually super comfortable. I got them from Audrey K Boutique. They're super cute. And these sunglasses, I feel like, really brought the dapperness to this dress. So that's what I wore day one. Now here's the big reveal, the big dapper day. And that is, well, I'm just gonna show it to you piece by piece. What am I talking about? So I was like, I don't know. I don't even know what I was going for, really. I'll just show you what I got. So I got this skirt from Marshalls, and it's kind of like pleated. It's a purple color, and it is not as dark as the camera's making it look right now, but it's like this purpley color. It has these little pleats in it. And my original concept was maybe I can get a petticoat and put it under here, and I'll be all like big and floofy. Never got the petticoat, but honestly, glad I did it. It was a good decision. It's super comfortable. I'm not normally a purple girl, but I actually really liked it. I like the flowers, and also it was one of the only skirts that wasn't a pencil skirt at any store I went to. So I got it. That was $15. Then I went to a local dance store because I do have a leotard, a black one, because that was like my thought. I was like, I'll wear something tucked in. Oh, I have a leotard, but it's long sleeves, and I'm so glad I didn't wear it because for almost the entire day on Dapper Day, it was muy caliente, and I would have been irritated if I had long sleeves. So I went to a local dance store and got this. It's a Capizio leotard. I also paid $15 for that. But for some reason, like the seams on this are like rough. And then with my backpack weighted on it, it was like digging into my arm. So it wasn't that cute. But there's that. And then the next part that I am super proud of is this little ascot. See, you do this and then you go like this. Here, let me turn up the brightness. You see that? You have like the little tail, and it's like cute and trendy, right? You wanna know what that's made out of? It's made out of leggings from Forever 21. That's right, I did that. Here I was thinking, maybe I can just buy one from a store. And then the world was like, nah, no. And then I found at the Dapper Day Expo, they did have little scarves because it's like a cute, trendy thing to do with your Dapper Day outfit. Anyway, I didn't wanna pay $8 for that. So I was like, you know what? I went to that after I bought the leggings, and then I was like, okay, if I don't like the leggings, I'll go buy the scarf for the next day. I didn't end up buying it because I liked how this looked. So I thought to myself while I was running around the mall, maybe, just maybe, I can go to Forever 21. I don't know where this idea came from. I'll go to Forever 21, get one of their camis, which are like $1.90, cut it up, and then make it into one of these. And while I went to Forever 21 and looked at the camis, right next to it were these leggings, a whole rack of them for $3.90. So yeah, it's $2 more. However, you get a whole lot more fabric. So I was able to just use one pant leg, and that was enough, but at least I had the option to use both pant legs if it wasn't enough. And all I did was cut off the front panel of this legging, and so I've got one full leg and one, you see that? There you go, you can finally see it. Just cut off the front panel, and I didn't do anything else to it. I didn't like close off the end or anything like that, just that, and it worked out great, and I was so happy with it. So there's that. And then the shoes I wore were these shoes that I got from Payless. They're sandals, and I know they're not the cute heels and whatever, but it matches this because of like that tan tone that kind of like pops out through there. You can see that, maybe, who knows. Also, because of my blisters, they worked. And then something that I realized while I was there is that people were wearing like Nikes with their dresses and like all this stuff, and I was like, oh, the shoes don't even matter. Yeah, it's great for like the what's it called, it's great for the gram, but like overall, people aren't like, people will look at your shoes if they're there and be like, those are great shoes, but they won't be like, those are atrocious shoes. So that's a good thing. I wore this lipstick, which is Sunday by ColourPop. It's a liquid matte, and it matte. It's like this pinky nude color, and it kind of goes with the tones of this. I decided not to go with red because I didn't think that looked good. And then of course, wore my sunglasses, and it was a good time. Something else that's kind of unrelated to this that I brought with me was this makeup wipe in a plastic bag. So that way I didn't have to carry around all my makeup wipes. And then like halfway throughout the day, I actually ended up taking off my lipstick because, as you can tell by my voice, I was getting sick and I wasn't feeling good, and the thought of lipstick on my lips just made me uncomfortable. So I took it off, and this was the best thing I've ever thought of. So this is maybe related to Dapper Day. Bring like maybe a couple of makeup wipes, but like put them in a plastic bag, and look, that takes up no room. You can just shove it in your bra if you wanted to. It was honestly the best idea I've ever had. I was very proud of myself. So that was my outfit. I'll go ahead and insert pictures here. I think I looked really cute. Dapper Day was a day that I felt pretty dapper, if I do say so myself. Here's the tea on the day of Dapper. It's a thing, I don't know. I mean, it was, I think what I really liked about Dapper Day is one, I felt really pretty and it was cool to get like nice pictures, especially because I have the annual pass that I call the Bad and Bougie Pass, and it pretty much comes with the photo pass photos. So I was having the photo pass photographers take my pictures with a nice camera and they came out pretty good. So got some pictures taken, was feeling myself, feeling cute, and then it was really cool to see everybody else's outfits. But like the day itself, there isn't like a Dapper Day event, at least that I experienced or I was a part of. The main gathering I feel like is the Dapper Day Expo, but it's more of like a shopping mall for Dapper Day things that is way out of my budget range. And I'm not saying that it's overpriced. I think those articles of clothing have a lot of effort put into them and maybe are hand sewn, but like I don't have the money for a $150 dress. Like that's just not in my budget, or for like $30 gloves. Like no, it's just not for me. It's just not. And I have nothing against people who spend their money on that. That's fine. Like that's your thing, do your thing. It's cool if you're like, hey, I want to look fly, dapper as heck, and I got money to blow. Ooh, Dapper Day Expo is for you, baby. So you should go. Now, Dapper Day itself, I don't know. It's just like, I don't think I would have stayed as long as I did if I didn't end up meeting up with a friend. And that's, you know, that's my own thing for like going by myself, and I wasn't feeling good. And so I like probably would have tapped out earlier. Ended up leaving the parks at about, I think like 8:30, maybe 9. By the time I got to my car, it was 9 o'clock. It was a long day. It was cool seeing everybody else's outfits, but otherwise it's just a normal day at Disney. Now I know Dapper Day, like the people who organize these events, don't do an official meetup to avoid crowding, because any Tom, Dick, or Harry can go, you know. Also, Disneyland would probably like not allow the event to happen or something like that. So there was no official meetups organized by Dapper Day. I do follow some like Disney Instagrammers on Instagram. That was unnecessary. And on their stories, some of them were like, yeah, like at this Dapper Day meetup in Toontown, or that's the only one that I saw, that a whole bunch of people were in Toontown. And then I know that they say on the website, like, hey, we encourage you to go on, what was it? The Mark Twain Riverboat and the King Arthur Carousel. Is that what it's called? The Carousel in Fairy Tale Town. The Carousel in Fantasyland, and then the Mark Twain Riverboat on the Rivers of America, like at New Orleans Square area. They say, hey, we encourage you to go on these rides because they're the first, they're opening day attractions that are still in the park. So like go on that, get a cute pic, have a fun moment. But there's no like organized meetups. The expo was, I think, appropriately priced. I would not pay more than $10 to go in there. And knowing what it is, I might not do it next year. I am pretty stoked that I got these sunglasses because they are really nice and I am gonna wear them like on the reg, you know? I think unless if there is like, oh, I need something for my outfit, or if I wanted one of those scarves, if that lady is still there next year, I don't think I would do it again. I don't think I'm gonna do a scarf again either because it gets a little hot, especially it was hot in the fall. It was November and it was hot. Anyway, that's Southern California. Oh yeah, and then for my hair, I just kind of did this, and then I did this, and then that was it. And then I did that on both sides, and then at one point I ended up putting my hair in a ponytail, and like that was it. My hair doesn't hold a curl, so I can't do the fancy curls like everybody else does, or like fancy stuff. My hair's just too thin and stringy. This was a little all over the place. So my Dapper Day, like I said, I hung out with a friend of mine who actually works in the parks, and it was just a casual day because she works in the parks, I'm always at the parks, so we just kind of hanging out. But I did do something I've never done before, and that was the Animation Academy, and there was Sully. We were there in time for Sully. I'm pretty proud of this. I think it looks good. I want to go back and do it again because my stupid head, once again, sick brain, work with me. I forgot the concept that there's no erasers, and she even says that. She's like, yeah, thin, light strokes. I wasn't doing that. And so you can see that there's an issue. Like, if you look at it here, it actually doesn't, like, it looks pretty good. But, like, here, I drew the lines too dark. But otherwise, I'm pretty happy with it. So anyway, like, just, you know, rode Alice in Wonderland. Did, I think, oh, yeah, I did Big Thunder, did Space Mountain in the front row. Holy cannoli. If you've never ridden Space Mountain in the front row, that's an experience. That was so, you know, I think if I get in the front, if I have the option, I think I'll do it again, because it was very fun, but it was super scary. Like, I couldn't stand up straight for a minute. Anyway, that was my Dapper Day. Overall, I had a fun time because I was in Disneyland. It was fun to see people's costumes. It's a good time. I would say if you're somebody who likes to go to Disneyland and you like to dress up, do it. Live your best life. For all the guys wearing four-piece, three-piece, seven-piece suits, I commend you, because it was way too hot for any of that for me. And I can only imagine now that they do it in Disney World too, oh, with the humidity, that's awful. So there's that. So yeah, I had a good day, but I saw, like, there's this girl I follow on Instagram. Her name is Magic with Celia, I think. She's cool. She makes cute posts and whatnot, but she made this post about Dapper Day, how she was, like, really nervous for it, and I guess she had, like, ordered pieces for her dress and, like, was gonna do it, but then, like, things were falling apart and she got really nervous, and so she was like, never mind, I'm not going. And then, like, last minute, she just, like, found a cute dress in her closet and, like, texted her friend and was like, okay, let's go, and she went and she had a really good time. But she was like, I was so stressed out and all that stuff, and I think maybe because I'm not, like, I guess as much into the Disney community as I thought I was, and I also, like, don't have a big following on social media, and I don't know those, like, big Disney Instagrammers, because there are some, like, really big Disney Instagrammers. But anyway, she was just really worried about being judged and all that stuff. And I think, like, the biggest thing is if you're somebody who's out there, like, judging people on if they're dapper enough, like, you need to leave, because you're an asshole. Like, what? That's so weird. And I felt bad for her that she was, like, so stressed out about this, because I get that, like, being socially accepted and all that stuff. But she looked really cute. Everybody looked great. Like, anybody who was anybody, like, who was dressed up looked great. And, like, even if it was, like, the littlest of dapper or the biggest, like, go all out on it, like, everybody looked really great, and it was really cool just being able to see everybody. I just wish I was feeling better. So with that being said, I think next year I'm going to bring my fanny pack and wear sneakers, because that's how I prefer to go to Disney. But I had a good time. If you've ever been to Dapper Day before, let me know what you think of Dapper Day, if you'll ever do it again, or if you've decided not to do it again, or if you go to every single Dapper Day and you've been to the ones in Florida and all that stuff. Tag me in your Dapper Day pictures, because I want to see everybody's outfits. I especially love the Disney bounds, or the ones that just go, like, all out, but I love seeing everybody's outfits. So if you have any questions about Dapper Day and you want to know my thoughts on your question or whatever, comment down below. As always, I'd love to hear your questions and respond to them. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing. I make videos about Disney stuff, tech stuff, everything in between. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and I have a podcast and a Patreon, so go ahead and check that out. The links for those are in the description down below as always. Otherwise, that is it for me. Stay beautiful, have a marvelous day, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!
Hi there. This is the point of the video where I like to thank my Patreon supporters. All these wonderful, beautiful people are at the Ethel tier or above when it comes to supporting me on my Patreon. And that means they pledge at least $10 a month. All these wonderful, beautiful people are so giving, and I just wanted to say thank you so very much. Now, if you want to be a supporter of guess who? Me on Patreon. You can go to patreon.com/Annelies and pledge your support to me in all of my endeavors, whether it be on YouTube or on my podcast or all things that are kooky and crazy in Annelies. Be sure to remember this kooky, quirky gal when you're supporting me on Patreon, and I really wish there was something else I could offer you, but this is what I'm working with.